I married Isis on the 5th day of May, but I could not hold on to her very long. So I cut off my hair and I rode straight away to the one unknown country where I could not go wrong. A high place of darkness and light. Dividing line ran through the center of town. I hitched up my pony to a post on the right. I went into a laundry to wash my clothes down. A man in the corner approached me for a match. I knew right away he was not ordinary. He said, "Are you looking for something easy to catch?" I said, "I've got no money." He said, "That ain't necessary." We set out that night for the cold in the north. I gave him my blanket and he gave me his word. I said, "Where are we going?" He said, "We'll be back by the 4th. I said, "That is the best news that I ever heard." I was thinking about turquoise. I was thinking about gold. Thinking about diamonds and the world's biggest necklace. As we rode through the canyons, through the devilish cold. I was thinking about Isis, how she thought I was so reckless. She told me that one day we would meet up again. Things would be different the next time we wed. If I only could hang on and just be a friend. Oh, I still can't remember all the best things she said. Yeah, we came to the pyramids all embedded in ice. He said, "There's a body I'm trying to find. If we carry it out, it'll bring a good price." It was then that I knew what he had on his mind. Well, the wind, it was howling, and the snow was outrageous. We chopped through the night and we chopped through the dawn. When he died, I was hoping that it wasn't contagious. I made up my mind that I had to go on. I broke into the tomb, but the casket was empty. There was no jewels, no nothing. I felt I'd been had. I saw that my partner, he had just been being friendly. When I took up his offer, I must have been mad. I picked up his body and I dragged him inside. Threw him down the hole and put by the cover. I said a quick prayer and I felt satisfied. I rode back to find Isis just to tell her I love her. She was there in the meadow where the creek used to rise, blinded by sleep and in need of a bed. I came in from the east with the sun in my eyes. I cursed her one time, then I rode on ahead. She said, "Where you been?" I said, "No place special." She said, "You look different." I said, "Well, I guess." She said, "You've been gone." I said, "That's only natural." She said, "You gonna stay?" I said, "If you want me to, yes." fickle child. What drives me to you is what drives me insane. I still can't remember the way that you smiled on the 5th day of May in the drizzling rain.